Santa Clarita Diet Season 3 just recently aired on Netflix, and man, it's a show I was so excited to see return with a new season, and I unfortunately binged it, you know, faster than I'm really proud to admit, but now that it's over, what's next, man? What's next for this, for the Hammonds? What's next for the Hammonds? I'm going to insert a spoiler warning because I will drop a few spoilers, but nothing too major. I still wouldn't watch this video, though, if you haven't seen Season 3 and you are interested in the TV show. If you're not interested and, you know, you just want to listen to one of my videos, then go ahead and continue on. Okay, so throughout most of the episodes, Sheila tries to convince Joel to become undead, become a zombie just like her. So they can both, you know, live forever because Sheila is undead now and she won't age and she doesn't want to lose Joel. Because, like I said, Sheila isn't going to age and Joel will age and then Joel will die and then Sheila will be alive. Just a messy situation. So she tries convincing Joel that he should become a zombie and become undead like her, and he doesn't really want to. Now, there's a more of a serious issue here because the Knights of Serbia are like a group of knights who pretty much want to wipe out the undead, and this is one of the many issues that Sheila and Joel face throughout this entire season. There's also another character in it that I love. I'm not going to say his name because I actually don't remember it, but he's in My Name is Earl, and he's in this TV show for this season, and I fucking love that guy. Anyway, in terms of like Eric and Abby, the whole relationship thing, they do kind of, you know, I guess build up to have more of a romantic kind of relationship in the TV show, but they don't get together. They don't get into a relationship. They just kind of take it to the next step without labeling anything. Now, they spend a lot of time convincing an FBI agent that they didn't blow up the fracking site as we've seen in the previous season. And I'm not going to spoil too much for you, so I won't elaborate, but the ending of the show is pretty important, and it seems like Abby finally kind of takes that step and shows that she's interested in having a relationship with Eric. And as for Sheila and Joel, well, Joel came to a decision that he wanted to become undead so they would live forever. Now, the reason he did was because they had like a near-death experience, and it kind of scared Joel that that may have been the last time he would see his wife. And Mr. Ball Legs, as we know, he looks like a big meatball. He ruined the moment, or she ruined, I don't know, she maybe, she ruined the moment by entering through Joel's ear canal and ends up killing Joel. And unfortunately, that forced Sheila to bite Joel and bring him back. So as Joel comes back and says hello, the TV show ends, basically ending off on a fucking huge cliffhanger. A huge one. Now, it's not confirmed if they'll be renewing the TV show and working on a fourth season, but man, I hope they do. I love the TV show. Probably the most entertaining TV show on Netflix, and that's in my opinion, of course. Stranger Things, man, you're close. You're very close, but you're not Santa Clarita Diet. So let's talk about Season 4. Okay, so if you're a big Santa Clarita fan, I can even say Santa Clarita fan, it's bad news, unfortunately. The creator Victor Fresco wanted to end off Season 3 the way he did, so the story couldn't be tampered with, or hampered with, is it? I think it was hampered with, yeah, in case Netflix decided to cancel the show. And it seems like the most, you know, original comedies don't last longer than 3 seasons on Netflix, so it has got a good run so far. And Victor told THR this: "We're aware that the show gets more expensive every year, and we're aware of, you know, what seems like Netflix's templates with the studio stuff. It seems like mostly 3-season stuff, and we know they like the show. I like to say humans there seem to love the show, but I don't know how the algorithm feels about us, and that algorithm makes a lot of decisions, ultimately. So I just don't know." Netflix is apparently known for not really alerting its, you know, show's creative team when the show is being cancelled. It sort of just, like, happens. So Victor is most probably thinking the same thing as us. Will the 4th season go ahead? We just don't know. Now, good news comes with bad news, sometimes. Victor did kind of talk about how he would tackle the future seasons. "I could see a scenario where the 4th year is the last year. I sort of imagine it going 5 years, and that seemed about right to me. I think we're introducing a huge new storyline for Season 4 if we do come back, and our challenge would be to come up with another one for Season 5. But I have no doubt, based on these characters and this life, that it would be something we could do." Fuck, why did I start with that? That it could be something we could do. So if you want to know whether or not Season 4 is going to happen, it's honestly up to Netflix. I doubt the cast would be opposed to making another season, but with the way the season ended, there's no reason they can't pick up on it, you know? Like, Joel becoming a zombie will be extremely interesting for fans to see. You know, how will he tackle being undead? He's fucking hated the whole experience for, like, Season 1, 2, and 3, so what the hell? But it all depends with Netflix, and if the viewership is high for this season, we might get one. If it isn't, then we probably won't. It would turn out to be one of the biggest shames if Netflix cancelled the show, and that's my opinion, of course. Like, man, I love the show. It's one of my favorite fucking shows right now. So what I'm going to say is by the looks of it, we will get it because the director or the creator knows what he wants to do with the future, and it has a good fan base. In my opinion, I think it's a pretty good fan base. So what I'm going to do is, any news that comes out, I'll make a video on it. I don't really cover, like, you know, TV shows. I haven't done that before, but this is something I'm really interested in. I really like. So what I'm going to do is, any update, I will let you know. Please, Netflix, if anybody from Netflix is watching this, of course they're not, but if this video gets 1 billion views and someone from Netflix somehow sees this, please let us hear Joel's story. Comment below if you want to see that. And if you enjoyed the newest season, if you've seen it before, I hope you've seen it before watching the video though. But if you enjoyed it, let me know in the comments. And if you didn't enjoy it, tell me why. Honestly, I love this season, so I'm just going to say that. I hope you enjoyed. And yeah, it's been Dylan. Have a nice weekend.